All right, welcome to another episode from the Chart Reader. So I think I'm going to chapter all of these together because really I think it's all the same thoughts across these. All right, so I'll probably cover at least the big four. We'll look at Rigetti, we'll look at IonQ, we'll look at QUBT, QBTS, and then if I don't run too long, maybe I'll add at least another three or four that I have in my head, right? But today was a good day. And I think it would be really easy to start, getting overly excited. And again, like I said, I'm seeing things continue after hours, right? Like I see it for sure. I think it's important to still maintain a little bit of caution, but there are definitely some interesting things happening that make me think, all right, maybe there's a little bit of window for more, okay? And the entire focus really, really is the NASDAQ. Okay, and again, without getting into too much of the thoughts now, we go from down here to up here this morning. You can see in the box over there, we open at 19,200 something, right? So big gap up really allowed the sector to just start well, accumulate a lot of the needed volume, and the rest kind of went from there, right? I think it is wildly critical to see what the NASDAQ does tomorrow. And can we at least come back towards that 50 moving average? I wouldn't call this a loss just yet. Obviously, three red candles, but hey, that is actually not a confirmation loss. Again, I'll go over this candle, but it's different than these three for a reason. This one's actually a good bad day as opposed to these bad days. All right. And again, I'll tell you what that means shortly, but NASDAQ has had a relatively decent last 2 days. Again, despite I obviously see the reds right there. And I think that's what helped it. And the question now will be, can we continue up to probably these two moving averages around here? Or are we going to lose this and head back down, right? And I think answering that question will dictate what continues or doesn't continue on these, right? So I'll give you my thoughts up and my thoughts down, but it's almost the same thoughts, right? The question really is, can we continue on up to these next two moving averages all the way up here? Or are we going to kind of come back down to this and maybe worse, right? And again, I think that's the theme across these. Can we come back up to this one? Are we going to go back down to the other one? QUBT, back to this one, down to the other ones. QBTS, back to that one, down to these ones, right? And again, the difference between the distances between that one and this one, that might help dictate where you want to keep your eyeballs at, right? But I think that's a solid amount. Hey, CPI data came out today. I'm not entirely sure if it was good or bad. Maybe the gap up was because it was at least all right. I'll be honest, I don't know. I was so busy at work today. I kind of was stepped away from the market and the info. But again, I think NASDAQ, like I said, is going to be the focus and kind of the echo across these. All right, so before we do go any further, though, and I give you more of my thoughts and opinions, what are we going to do? Same thing we always do, right? We'll take a look at the daily and the weekly to see how these things are setting up short term. We have our five moving averages. There are horizontal support and resistance lines that I do draw manually myself. Excuse me. And then when we are done up here, we'll use the MACD, RSI, and volume as our lower indicators. Hey, really quickly, if you can, please subscribe to this channel. Share this video online with your friends. Comment good or bad if you disagree. Look, anything you can do helps so much with these YouTube algorithms. But for real, just being here, giving me your time, oh, I'm so grateful for it. All right. So, I'm at least going to talk about the four on this first chapter. If I don't run too long, I'll make another chapter for a couple others that I have thoughts on. But really, look, Rigetti, you can see it, able to hold the 50 moving average, able to use it as a support, and more than anything, by a lot, it destroys the 50-day volume line. And actually, today was the biggest volume day. This day right here, you can see the volume was 3,012,000 near the bottom. This day right here was 3,005,000. Today was 3,042,000. share, 342 million shares. I think I said the numbers wrong, but you get it, right? This was the biggest single volume day in the entire run. And I think to me, it just reminds me how hungry people are to trade, how hungry everyone is to see the red, red, red turn into green, 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 right? And I think I want to just say the word responsible, right? Like I feel like the chart reader's voice has gotten bigger than I ever expected it to, but I am at least responsible to talk about the caution than just blind optimism here, all right? Normally, any given good moment with the indices, I would say monster support, monster volume. Looks like we're trying to go from the 40 back to 60, whatever, back to 90, whatever, right? Like, no, I think what really, really matters, what really, really matters is what NASDAQ does. So let's talk about the last 2 days real quick, all right? Monday, yesterday, actually opens down here at 18,900, the second number, and then goes all the way up and closes all the way up here at 19,000 and change. Obviously, that's well below where we closed yesterday, right? Or Thursday or Friday, whatever, right? But this is a good, bad day. This day actually went up, even though we went down and it wasn't good, right? That alone actually adds a decent amount of optimism to the next candle. Again, nothing's guaranteed, right? But hey, you can kind of see it here. This was actually a decent one and you still get that same gap up. This was obviously not. This one goes up here, but then opens down here, right? So again, nothing's perfect and you get that, right? But that's something we look for. And especially if the candle's that big, that's an interesting, good, bad day, okay? So again, this morning we gap up again, we close up here at 19,088, the green number you see there, and then open $200 higher basically. That's a big gap up right there. That's gonna add excitement and you can see it across all of these. That first 15 minutes, monster, right? Today was the 14th, monster, monster first 15, QBTS. Monster, monster, first 15. QUBT, monster, 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 big right there, right? QSI, big one right there, right? IonQ, big one right there, right? Everyone, ARQQ, let's even go to the smaller ones, big one right there, right? QMMO, no, QMCO. There's another one, right? You can tell, like, I'm going deep into the hole. All of them got love in that first 15 minute candle, right? And that's what NASDAQ will do. I think the other important, look at how much volume came, right? What was the entire day on this one? The entire day was 1.7. What was that first 15 minutes? It was 300K of that, right? So, I mean, a significant amount was that. And hey, this wasn't a good volume, but those first two right there, significant, right? So a lot of real, real big momentum was able to come. And then from there, volume kind of started to dictate the rest, right? Rigetti actually does what a lot of them couldn't do, which was continue and go, right? We saw, what was it, QBTS? I think that was, oh, this one actually did it too. Maybe it was QUBT. Yeah, this was the one that started well and just couldn't quite get back up to it. Looks like after hours, though, it actually has already gotten there and then some, right? So again, there's interesting things going on, and I see where it's easy to be optimistic, right? What we're looking for is tomorrow's NASDAQ, okay? Can we basically, I think it's here. I think that's what I'd be looking for at the minimum. We basically want to get to like 19,170. I think if we can get into that range, all of a sudden I'll be thinking 19,003. Sorry, my throat. Something's like going around in LA if I had to guess. I don't know. But I would be hopeful that we can go up to this red line. If we can make this little baby uptrend right here, that will do significant things for the little stocks underneath it, all right? I'm not sure if we'll break that. I think this is gonna become a really tough test right here. If we do, the next place up is there, right? And again, that will just echo across these, okay? If we fall back to 19,000 or lower, that's where the worry is going to start to pick back up again. All right. So look at NASDAQ. What NASDAQ does, so will the others. You know, the last thing I want to show on NASDAQ, okay, and then I'll get into the specifics. The last 15 minutes on the NASDAQ chart was monstrous. It actually broke three moving averages on a single candle. All right. And really, you can say the last 45 minutes, right? 15, 15, 15. The last 45 minutes were actually really strong as well, right? So in a lot of ways, there's some decent optimism the way that the NASDAQ ended. Again, I'm not here to just blindly accept that optimism, especially as I'm seeing this downtrend forming, especially as I'm seeing a tougher S&P 500 downtrend forming, and as I'm seeing this Dow Jones go like this, right? If Dow Jones can start to get over here, because Dow Jones was the worst, all of a sudden I'll start being a little bit more optimistic too. So, you know, as much as I care about the NASDAQ, I'm still looking here as well, right? So I realize that was a lot more index than quant, but I think that was super important to go into these thoughts, right? So again, if NASDAQ can continue, look, there is green, 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 red, 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 a pretty, I don't want to say easy path, but there's a really smooth path to basically 1250. If you look at the actual box over there, it's 1260 where the 20 moving average is sitting right there, right? So that's a pretty significant jump from the under nine that we're at, right? 369, you're going to add another three. That's a 33% move from where we're sitting at if we go up, right? If we were to go down, I think the first worry point would be 770. I think if we lose 770, we actually might quickly fall back down into that 650 range that we took off from. So I would say it is very bullish over eight. I think coming to eight is where I'd start to question things. And yeah, that 770 line, that's where I'd be a little worrisome, right? I don't even think we necessarily have to wait for the golden line. I think if this does continue, and so does NASDAQ, this should just red, 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 green, green, green to there. You know what I mean? I don't want to downplay the resistance of this, because obviously we're now under it, but I think we got over that golden line pretty well, and I think it was just the index that brought us back. But maybe I should add a little more caution to that, but honestly, I think I just see enough red, 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 green, 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 little resistance, right? Like the resistance on that would basically be 1330, right? And I'm actually only saying 1260. So that's kind of where my thoughts are at right there again. So with the next one, let's look at IonQ next. Look, I can see this coming all the way up here to 33. Okay, I could see that being the next point. That's also a decent resistance right there, right? It's basically the bottom of that. It's basically the bottom of that, around 32.50, around 33, something like that, right? But yeah, that's a nice red, red, red to green, green, green. It wasn't as big a volume, right? When I look at RGTI, I'm even talking less number. This thing destroys the 50-day line, right? IonQ got over it, and hey, that's a good thing. But yeah, not quite that same destroyed volume. But yeah, I see the after-hours push. Maybe that is because of, like I said, the bullishness of the last 15 minutes on NASDAQ, last 45 minutes on NASDAQ. But yeah, I think seeing how that opens is going to be real critical. Again, sorry, let me give both sides of the coin, right? So I'm looking for this thing to get to basically 33. If we can break 33, I think the next point would be like 36.80, give or take. I would be worried. Oh, that's where. And that's where we wicked. It's that. I would be worried at $26.35. If that is lost, it will be a very fast fall down to 21. All right. So be careful around that. Yeah, 26.40, 26.35. You lose that, you're coming down here, right? But I can see this trying for 33.25, hopefully can get over that and maybe do its best to get as high as like 36.30. I don't know if it'll get over 36.30, because give or take in the time it takes to try to get there, that eight moving average is probably going to come down there, right? So I would use that as my 1-2 lines up right there on IonQ. QBTS. Let's take a look at that one next. Okay, cool. So this one is at least at the 50. So really that would mean the next, excuse me, I'm so sorry. The next place this is going to try to go is all the way at 7 something. And yeah, you can see it's already trying to start the climb after hours, right? But again, it's all about NASDAQ. If NASDAQ continues, I could see this $5 basically being a tough test. But man, if this thing gets over 5, 7, 13 really is green, 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 red, red, green, green, red, 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 green, green, all the way up there. This one's an interesting one, and that's a very healthy gain right there if it can make it, right? That's basically another 50% right there, right? If we were to lose, man, I guess it's going to be you, but that's too low. No, I would reuse the wick, I guess. All right, we'll use that. I think if this thing starts to touch $3.95, $3.93 is where I'm clicking right now, but $3.90, $3.98, anything in the 90s, I would start to get scared. Under 4 is worrisome, because if you lose 4, the next place down is 280. And that's a tough, tough drop right there, right? So this one's a real big and a real interesting risk reward. You're either gaining 50 or you're basically losing 50 right here, right? So QBTS, I would say, is probably the biggest risk reward of the ones that we've just seen. And then QUBT is the last one I want to look at. Man, my throat is getting a little annoying, actually. But I could see this trying to go as high as 880. If it breaks 880, I would guess 1114. If we lose, oh man, we're base. That's exactly where the doji was. Look at that. All right, it's that. If we go into 660 or under, it will start to go very quickly to 480. Okay, so there's a lot going on right now. And believe me, it would be so easy for me to be wildly bullish. I would probably get more views if I was just wildly bullish. What I still see is a downtrend. I think the most optimistic thing I saw was the Dow Jones. This one went from really hardcore down to maybe kind of trying. But hey, even from there to there, that's still a pretty bad downtrend right there, right? And it really still hasn't broken very many moving averages. But this, like I said, went from the horrible of horrible scaries to, all right, it's trying to do a little better. At this point, S&P 500 is still going a little bit on the downtrendy side, right? So let's see if the other ones can recover and do it quick enough so that NASDAQ doesn't see enough pain. Watch NASDAQ. I'm telling you, even if it just gaps up, that alone could do a lot like we saw today. And then just be a little extra cautious, finger on the mouse if you need to, all right? Let me know your thoughts. Let me know your opinions. Even if you disagree, oh, I appreciate you so, so much.